Welcome back. What I'm going to tell you about in this video clip is a chemical synthesis of DNA. Now, as I mentioned in the last video clip, the size difference accelerates the purification process. The chemical synthesis that makes the best use of size difference is called solid phase synthesis. So in this video clip, I'm going to introduce solid phase synthesis. In the solid phase synthesis, the size of one substance is magnified. Before the starting reaction between A and B, for example, A is attached to the large beads. Here is large beads. The A is attached to the large beads. Then the size of A becomes the thousands of times larger than that of B. Then this size difference allows us to distinguish A from B. When B is added in large quantities, almost 100% of A will be reacted with B, producing AB on the large Bs. In this case, excess B should be there, which can be rinsed out. If a filter is used, AB attached to the large Bs can be easily separated from the non-reactive B. So next, you start a second reaction by adding excess amounts of C to the AB sample attached to the large Bs. From the last reaction, you got AB attached to the large Bs. Then you add excess amount of C this time. Because C reacts with B, ABC is formed on the large Bs. The plus, you have non-reactive C left. So once the non-reactive C is rinsed out using the size difference, you can start the third reaction by adding the excess amount of D. You take this one, you can purify that. Now you have ABC on the large Bs. You add the excess amount of D, then you'll get ABCD on the large Bs plus excess amount of D. You can rinse out the excess amount of D. So this process continues until you have added the desired number of substances. You can go further. So if the DNA components are used in the manner I mentioned here, you can be, they can be bonded one after another to build a long DNA strand. So in the next video clip, I'm going to tell you about the DNA synthesis.